Yes, Sharon, we had started the topic clauses, and related to that, we had already discussed simple sentences, compound sentences, and today we are to start with a complex sentence. And from complex sentence, we will have So first of all, let's see what makes a sentence complex. It is the formation of two or more subordinate clauses along with the principal clause, which makes it complex. Okay, there has to be one principal clause, then subordinate clause, and together it will be one complex sentence. Now, what is principal clause? Principal clause is the one which has a subject, a verb, and even an object. But even then, the meaning doesn't seem to be very, very clear. Okay, despite it has a subject and verb and object also. But even then, it doesn't convey a complete meaning. Okay, grammatically, it seems to be correct. But meaning-wise, it doesn't seem to be correct. So that is why it is principal clause. Okay, the other one which makes a complex sentence is subordinate clause. It's a clause which has, it also has a subject and verb. It also has a subject, verb, and all. But it depends upon the principal clause. Without principal clause, subordinate clause cannot stand. Okay, subordinate clause is totally incomplete without principal clause. What is principal clause? Which has its own subject and verb and even object. And it seems to be grammatically complete but doesn't convey a complete sense. It can stand on its own. Got it? But the subordinate clause is the one which doesn't stand on its own. It depends upon principal clause. Is this much clear? Now let me explain this with the help of an example. If I say, he told me, it's okay, he subject, told is verb and me is object, full stop. He told me. Grammatically, there is no problem. It seems to be a sentence. I can call it a sentence. Subject is there, verb is there. I can call it a sentence. But it's not a sentence, it's a clause because it is not conveying a complete meaning. After it, he told me, you have to tell what. He told me what. Hona chahiye. That's why it's a clause. Clear? Bigger than phrase but shorter than a sentence is clause. He told me that. He would go there. So he told me that he would go there. So he told me is the principal clause, and that he would go there is a subordinate clause. See, the just remove this now. If I just say this, that he would go there, if I make it capital, if I start a sentence like this, that he would go there, you will say, ma'am, it is incomplete. That he would go there, but who is saying this? So this is not possible. Subordinate clause is not possible without principal clause. Got it? It is subordinate because it is dependent upon principal clause. So principal clause is mandatory and subordinate clause depends upon that for its own existence. it doesn't have its existence. Okay, it is like the second story of a building. Ground floor is, principal clause is the ground floor. Okay, and on the ground floor only you can make one first floor or second floor or third floor or even 20 floors. But without ground floor, no other floors are possible. So principal clause is the ground floor. Clear? And subordinate clauses are the other floors on it. Got it? So, okay. So when we say principal clause and subordinate clause, principal clause is always the same. But subordinate clauses can be of three kinds. How many kinds of subordinate clauses? Three. They are noun clause, adjective clause, yes, and adverb clause. Noun clause is which acts like a noun. Adjective clause is which acts like an adjective, and adverb which acts like an adverb. Right? If I say noun, leave noun. Adjective. So the subordinate clause should stand as an adjective to the principal clause. So adjective is what? Something which qualifies a noun or a pronoun is adjective. What is adverb? Which qualifies a verb or an adjective or even an adverb. What's an adverb? Adverb tells more about a verb or an adverb or an adjective. Adverb qualifies an adverb also. Okay? He ran fast. If I say he ran fast, what is fast here? Adverb. It is adverb. Because fast is about the ran. How he ran? How he ran? Fast. So fast is adverb. But if I want to add one more adverb to fast, what it will be? Can there be an adverb which can qualify adverb? Very easy. When I will tell you, you will say, yeah, we know do this. Yes, very. He ran very fast. He ran extremely fast. He ran horribly fast. He ran terribly fast. So these are all adverbs. Very also adverb and fast also adverb. Got it? These are adverbs. Then there are adverbial phrases. What will be the adverbial phrase? In a fast manner. He ran in a fast manner is adverbial phrase. Got it? What is phrase? Phrase is a group of words which act like which qualify a verb or an adverb or an adjective. When I say fast, this fast word is, it's an adverb. It's a word, okay? It's a word, adverb. But when I say in a fast manner, this is adverb phrase. Ye phrase hai, wo word tha. First of all, in your language come the alphabets A, B, C, then come words, fast, then comes phrase, in a fast manner, bunch of crooks, okay, bunch of keys, pride of lions, parliament of crows, okay, litter of puppies. These are all phrases, okay, in an awkward manner, phrase. So phrases are group of words which don't have a verb. What is a phrase? The group of words which don't have a verb. Then comes clause. clause has a verb, but clauses don't convey complete meaning. I've told you right now. It can be principal clause, it can be subordinate clause. Principal clause is single. Principal hai. Principal is principal. Then it has subordinate clauses. Ab teachers are subordinates. And subordinate clauses are three: noun clause, adjective clause, and adverb clause. So when we are talking about clauses, then we have to remember that we must write that that adjective or adverb or noun in a manner of phrase. If I say he ran fast, here I am using adverb. But if I say he ran in a fast manner, I am using adverbial phrase. But if I want to use this in an adverbial clause, then what will I do? Come on. Try to make fast adverbial clause. I've told you, like, clause is made up of a subject. It can have a verb. Try to make it. Apply your mind. Use fast to make it an adverbial clause. So, first there should be a principal clause. Banao ek. Yes. Start karo. It's starting can be he ran. Aage start karo. He ran dash. Complete it with the help of an adverbial phrase clause. If I say complete it with adverbial phrase, then you will say he ran in a fast manner, right? If I say complete it with an adverb, then you will say he ran fast. But I am saying complete it with an adverbial clause. Up karo. Shall I write it? So he ran. I'm not helping you. Okay. I'm helping me to explain what I have to write. You do your work. He ran fast. It is adverb. He ran in a fast manner. In a fast manner is adverbial phrase. Then third is he ran. It should be clause now, adverbial clause. That is your job. Career. It's very easy. Clause is the one which has a verb also. It can have a subject also. In a way, same expression you have to bring in the form of a clause. You don't have to apply mind only in maths. Even English requires mind. Try to give answer. Maybe what you are thinking that might be right, because its answer is not very smooth kinds. It may have various options, but there should be one verb. That's it. And fast should also be there. Yes, Khushi, give answer. I'm saying the same thing. You may not be sure, but maybe your answer is correct. Yes, that is correct. But did you say was in between? Yes, that is correct. That is correct. He ran at a speed that was very fast. Or you can say he ran in a manner that was very fast. pause should come. So you have to expand. You have to expand this phrase into a sentence now. He ran in a manner or in the manner that was very fast. He ran in the manner that was very fast. So now, in the manner that was very fast is adverbial clause, or you can say subordinate clause. When you talk about adverb clause or adverb phrase, then you must be knowing what is adverb. Adverb is, number one, you know that it qualifies a verb or an adverb or an adjective. Then what are the kinds of adverbs? Adverb of time, place, manner, right? Time wali when, where wali where, and how manner. When, where, how. The words which answer when, where, how are adverbs. Then there are adverbs of frequency and all. So basically, when you would remember adverb of time, place, and manner, then you'll be able to remember the usage of adverb in its various clauses. When you talk about adjective, then what is adjective? Something which qualifies a noun or pronoun. For example, adjective of quality, adjective of quantity, adjective of number, adjective of, okay? So for example, beautifully, nicely, okay, several, many, few, a few, these are all adjectives. So putting them in the form of a clause, that is another thing. And noun, you know, noun is something which is a name given to a given idea. Okay, it's a name given to anything, any person, or any idea. When you know the basic concept, then you can have the same idea for clauses also. Okay, now let us talk about the clauses one by one. Here my purpose was only to introduce you to the clauses. Now let us first talk about noun clause. Though adverb clause we have done, but still it will be done in details. Write down. He asked me what my name was. He asked me what my name was. Is it a complex sentence or compound or simple sentence? It's a complex sentence. Why? Because there are two clauses. He asked me is principal and it is subordinate. It is subordinate clause. No? So principal clause is okay, but what kind of subordinate clause is it that we have to now determine? Pay attention over here. He asked me what? He asked me what my name was. So when you get an answer to what from the subordinate clause, it happens to be a noun clause. Okay? When you get an answer to what, you get a subordinate clause, which is a noun clause. Okay, another task here, side by side. Can you turn this complex sentence into a simple sentence? Yes, he asked me my name. Yes, very good. He asked me my name. Here is the answer to those children who, when doing narration, ask me, hey, ma'am, ye answer wrong to you. In the narration, you are asked the question like he said to me, comma inverted comma start, what is your name? Then the answer is, he asked me what my name was. And some children come and say, like, ma'am, why isn't it so? Like, he asked me my name. This is the answer. When you are changing the narration into indirect form, then you require to do this in the complex sentence. but it becomes a simple sentence, that is wrong. Is that clear? This is the difference between these two. So this was the noun clause. He asked me what my name was. Okay, next sentence. He is the boy, right? He is the boy. Who helped me in distress? He is the boy who helped me in distress. What is distress? Difficulty, any adverse time. It's okay. Can you tell me whether it is simple or compound or complex sentence? Okay, those who say simple sentence, they raise hand. No one? You don't like simple sentence? Simple are the best sentence. Okay, for those who say it's a compound sentence, they raise hand. Okay, those who like compound sentences, you like? So is it a compound sentence? No. So it has nothing to do with your liking? Yes. You were saying compound sentence, some people were saying. Ab kya ho gaya? Yes, Harshdeep. Ab complex kaise ban gayi hai? 1 minute earlier it was compound. Sentences are not turn quotes. Okay, ye change nahi karte apne aap ko bichare. Bahut acche hai. Yes, it is a complex sentence. Why is it complex? Because it has got two parts. One part is, he is the boy. Ye principal clause. Par ye kyun nahi hai principal clause? Kyun sentence kyun nahi hai? Because it's not a complete sentence. He is the boy. Then what? Which boy? Batana padega na. So principal, and this is, who helped me is subordinate. Now, what kind of subordinate clause? Thoda suniye. He is the boy who. The clauses which start with who, whose, whom, which, that. Write down 5 words. The words, the subordinate clauses which start with who, whose, whom, which, that are adjective clauses. Who, whose, W-H-O-S-E. W-H-O-S-E, whose, whom, H, W-H-O-M. The clauses which start with who, whose, whom, which, that are called adjective clauses. Why adjective clauses? Ek to one, you have learnt it. Like it is coming with who, that's adjective. But you can understand it also. Here, this who refers to the boy. It is describing the boy. Which boy? The one who helped me. He is the boy who helped me in distress. Can you convert this sentence into a simple sentence? Anyone else? You can change its format, doesn't matter. He helps me in distress. The boy helped me in distress. Aap aise kuch bolenge. But I want ki like adjective bhi hona chahiye wahan pe. Woh to beta clause hi reh gayi. Beta, that is also clause, complex sentence. The answer is, he is a helpful boy. He is a helpful boy in distress. Okay, basically I want an adjective. Helpful is an adjective. This is the boy who helps me in distress. Okay, now third one, we have already done one example of adverbial clause. What was that? Okay, write up more example. He wrote dash. Soch ke kaha. Okay, write down one example. He wrote a poem. He wrote a poem that was very. He wrote a poem that was very. Kaisi honi chahiye poem? That was very inspirational. Very bad children. Always think negative things. He wrote a poem that was very inspirational. Who said boring? He wrote a poem that was very inspirational. Tell me what kind of sentence is it? Chant, you tell. He wrote a poem that was very inspirational. Saket. What kind of sentence is it? Super complex. Why? But how is it a complex sentence? He wrote a poem that was very inspirational. Because the sentence has got two parts. One is he wrote a poem. He wrote a poem. Underline this much is principal clause. That was very inspirational is subordinate clause. Now, what kind of subordinate clause is it? That was very, so that refers to the poem. So it is adjective clause again. Okay, now I do next thing. He said it. He said it in a very depressing tone. Yes, what kind of sentence is it, Ruhani?
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Ruhani, yes.
Ma'am, the sentence, he said it in a very depressing
tone.
Tone. Ma'am, it is a simple sentence.
Yes, correct. Very good. Silent clapping for Ruhani. Okay, today open dictionary and learn the meaning of silent. Okay. So he said it in a depressing tone. Now turn this into a complex sentence. Now Jyotsarup, you will be giving the answer. Ruhani, yes.
Ma'am, the answer would be, he said it in a tone that was very depressing.
Yes, very good. Again, silent clapping for Ruhani. He said it in a tone that was very depressing. Okay, so we'll continue tomorrow. It's over for the day. Thank you very much.